Very good morning. In the last class, we have seen what is meant by processor, various processors available in the market, what processor does in the computer. Today, in this class, we are going to see features and advantages of various processors. This comes under system board and mass storage devices chapter. In this class, we are going to see the Intel P4, Celeron, Xeon, Itanium processors and etc. So these are the various processors we are going to discuss in this class. There are Intel Pentium 4, Intel Celeron, Intel Xeon, Intel Itanium processors and AMD Athlon manufactured by Advanced Micro Devices. Here also we are going to see what is meant by dual core, core to Duo and quad core. And also we will see Intel I series microprocessors i3, i5 and i7. So now let us see all these microprocessors. First, we are going to see the Intel P4. It was very popular in its days. Intel P4 was released on November 20, 2000. The Pentium 4 is a line of computer processors developed and manufactured by Intel. They were single core processors originally based on an architecture code named Willimetri and were used in desktop and laptop computers until the late 2000s. These processors were the successor to the Pentium 3. Their development began about 2 years earlier when Pentium 2 was Intel's flagship consumer processor. This is a picture of Intel Pentium processor. The first Pentium microprocessor based on Willimetri and Northwood cores as well as some Prescott processors were referenced by their speed. To differentiate between Pentium 4 CPUs running at the same frequency but having different features, Intel used one letter suffix appended to CPU frequency. Here are the suffixes we can see. A means Northwood microprocessors with 512 kilobyte L2 cache for frequencies 2 GHz and lower, or Prescott CPUs with 1 MB L2 cache for frequencies higher than 2 GHz. The suffix B indicates processors with 533 MHz and front side bus FSB frequency. The suffix C processors featuring hyper-threading technology and 800 MHz FSD. The suffix E indicates Prescott's CPUs with 1 MB L2 cache. So these are the suffixes A, B, C and E used to indicate the different features of Intel processors and also CPU frequencies. All Pentium 4 processors were manufactured in three types of packages. 423-pin PGA package. Here PGA means pin grid array. PGA package for socket 423 motherboards and 478-pin micro PGA that worked in socket 478 motherboards and pin less 775 LAN LGA. Here LGA means LAN grid array. LGA package that required socket 775 motherboards. Socket 478 package was used by both desktop and mobile microprocessors, while two other packages were designed for desktop systems only. The next series processor is Intel Celeron. Celeron is a family of low-end x86 microprocessors developed by Intel and targets the ultra-cheap PC market. Celeron is the lowest tier x86 family offered by Intel, below Pentium, and has significantly lower performance capabilities than the higher-end processors. This Celeron processor is introduced in the April of 1998. Celeron is Intel's second longest serving family of processors after Pentium. Today, Celeron processors are available as dual core, running at higher speeds with more cache built directly into the core CPU. The addition of cache helps alleviate some of the cache issues that brought the original Celeron some very harsh reviews. These are the pictures of Intel Celeron microprocessor. Here we can see the next processor is Intel Xeon processor. The Intel Xeon is a high-end Intel processor for enterprise servers and workstations that runs on compatible Xeon motherboards. The Xeon processor aimed and served and manufactured for servers and workstations to improve the capability of servers and also workstations. Xeon processors use a slot 2 form factor and are available in speed starting at 400 MHz. Since Anacona released in June 2004, all Intel Xeon processors are 64-bit processors. Earlier, the processors were 32-bit processors, even 16-bit processors, even 8-bit processors. This is the picture of Intel Xeon processor. Intel Xeon is a high-performance version of Intel desktop processors intended for use in servers and high-end workstations. Xeon family spans multiple generations of microprocessor cores and two microarchitecture generations, NetBurst, Pentium 4 and Core. Xeon CPUs have the same features as Pentium 4D, Core Studio, Quad desktop microprocessors. Additionally, Xeon CPUs can work in dual processor systems also. Special version of Xeon CPUs, Xeon microprocessor can be used in four-way systems. Also, Xeon CPUs often have larger size of level 2 cache and include large level 3 cache. This is about Xeon processor. The Intel Xeon CPUs are almost always packed in differently from Pentium 4, Pentium D and Core 2 microprocessors, and with few exceptions can work only in server class motherboards. First Xeon CPUs were introduced in 603-pin package. This package was quickly replaced by 604-pin package that fits socket 604 motherboards. Many modern Xeon processors are also manufactured in 771 LAN FC-LGA. FC means flip chip, LGA means LAN grid array package. These processors require socket 771 motherboards. The next series of microprocessor is Itanium processors. Itanium is a name for brand of Intel processors that use the 64-bit RISC architecture. Here RISC means Reduced Instruction Set Computing. LATANM is based on RISC architecture. They are based on explicitly parallel instruction computing design philosophy, which states that the compiler should decide what instructions should be executed together. This is the Itanium 2 processor. Here we can see the picture of the Itanium 2 processor. Itanium is Intel's first microprocessor that is based on the 64-bit architecture known as IA64, Instruction Architecture 64. Developed under the code name of MERSD, Itanium and its underlying architecture are expected to provide a foundation for the next generation of software for the server and high-end workstation markets. Itanium, in addition to supporting a 64-bit processor bus and a set of 28 registers, that 64-bit design allows access to a very large memory. In addition, the architecture exploits features in explicitly parallel instruction computing, that is EPIC, a giant Intel and Hewlett-Packard development effort. These provide advances in the parallel processing handling of computer instruction known as prediction and speculation. So next processor is AMD Athlon. This is completely different from Intel manufacturers because AMD is manufactured by Advanced Micro Devices Company. It's very popular along with some of the Intel processors. AMD Athlon, popular computer processor from AMD, nothing but Advanced Micro Devices, that has a 266 MHz front side bus, support for PC 2100 DDR memory and run set speeds of 1 GHz to 1.33 GHz. There are also AMD Athlon processors with a 200 MHz front side bus, support for PC 1600 DDR memory and run set speeds of 900 MHz to 1.3 GHz speed. Athlon is the brand name applied to a series of x86 compatible microprocessors designed and manufactured by Advanced Micro Devices. The original Athlon, now called Athlon Classic, was the first 7th generation x86 processor and was the first desktop processor to reach speeds of 1 GHz, and it was introduced on June 23, 1999. AMD has continued using Athlon name with 64-bit Athlon 64 architecture, the Athlon 2 and the Accelerated Processing Unit, APU chips targeting the socket EM1 desktop SoC architecture and the socket EM4 Gen micro architecture. This is the Athlon architecture of CPUs. Here we can see the 64B KB instruction cache, prediction code cache, branch prediction table, fetch and decode control area, instruction decoders, this is the instruction control unit, and integer scheduler, this is the bus interface unit, and the stack map scheduler, a register file. Here we can see the cache controller and 64KB data cache. Here is the system interface. We can see this is a typical architecture of Athlon microprocessor. Here we can see the picture of AMD Athlon processor. This is the AMD Athlon processor. There is another picture we can see. This is the AMD Athlon processor. Athlon has an 86x86 compatible processor architecture that comes with a fully pipelined superscalar floating point unit, a 128 kilobyte L2 and L1 and L2 caches that is built into the microprocessor chip, and a programmable backside bus to a L1 and L2 caches. A notable feature is the system's 200 MHz bus available in AMD Athlon processor. The Athlon chip uses AMD's aluminium 0.18 micron technology. As the successor to the AMD's K6 microprocessor, Athlon was previously called K7. Now we are going to see next 12 core processor generally and processor's terminology when you are purchasing. Common people say dual core processor, quad core processor and core to dual processor, octa-core, like that. So what is meant by core, and here what is the dual core processor we see. When referring to computer processors, dual core is a technology that enables two complete processing units or cores to run in parallel on a single chip. Here we can say a core is a processor, single processor. And this gives the user virtually twice as much power in a single chip. A dual core processor is a CPU with two processors or execution cores. We can say execution cores in the same integrated circuit. Each processor has its own cache and controller, which enables it to function as efficiently as a single processor. Nothing but each processor as having independent cache and controller with it. Because the two processors are linked together, they can perform operations up to twice as fast as a single processor can. Dual core processor. For the computer to take full advantage of dual core, it must be running on an operating system that supports TLP and for applications to support TLP. TLP means thread level parallelism. TLP is a software capability that allows high-end programs such as a database or web applications to work with multiple threads at the same time. Programs that support this facility, this ability, can do a lot more even under high levels of workloads. Dual core processor, the Intel Core Duo, the AMD X2, and the dual core PowerPC G5 are examples of the CPUs that use dual core technologies. These are the examples: Intel Core Duo, AMD X2, and the dual core PowerPC G5. These CPUs each combine two processor cores on a single silicon chip. This is different than a dual processor configuration in which two physically separate CPUs work together. So dual processor means two processors CPUs work together. So dual core is having two cores, two processors on a single chip. Dual core processors are well suited for multitasking environments because there are two complete execution cores instead of one, each with an independent interface to the front side bus. Since each core has its own cache memory, the operating system has sufficient resources to handle most compute intensive tasks in parallel. Next one, core to dual processor. This is referred to as the Centrino Duo. The Core Duo was the Intel's first dual core processor developed for mobile computers and was first released on January 5, 2006. It was also the first Intel processor to be used with Apple Macintosh computers. Core Duo processor, sometimes abbreviated as C2, the Intel Core 2, is a family of processors first introduced with the release of the Intel core to Duo processor on July 27, 2006. The core 2 processors include the C2D, nothing but core to Duo, C2E, core to Extreme, C2Q, core to Quad, and core to Solo. The core 2 Extreme was released on July 29, 2006 with 4 MB of shared L2 cache like the Intel core 2 Duo, but as a higher clock speed and capability being overlapped. This is a picture of Intel core 2 Duo processor manufactured by Intel, micro Intel company. Now we see quad core processor. What is meant by quad core processor? When referring to computer processors, quad core is a technology that enables 4 complete processing unit cores to run in parallel on a single chip. Having this many cores give the user virtually 4 times as much power in a single chip. For the computers to take full advantage of quad core, it must be running on an operating system that supports TLP and for application to support TLP, thread level parallelism. TLP is nothing but thread level parallelism. So quad core means 4 number of microprocessors are embedded on a single chip. So there are 4 cores, which increases the speed of computing. A quad core CPU has 4 processing cores in a single chip. It is similar to a dual core CPU, but has 4 separate processors rather than 2, which can process instructions at the same time. Some examples of quad core CPUs include the Intel Core 2 Quad, Intel Nehalem, and AMD Phenom X4 processors. These are the examples for quad core processors. These are the processors which are using quad core technology. The Intel processors are used in Mac, Macintosh, Windows, and Linux systems, while the AMD processors are only used in Windows and Linux systems. While 4 cores may seem impressive, some high-end computers have 2 quad core CPUs, giving them total of 8 processing cores, thus increasing the speed of the computer. So that the computer can do more processing at a time. Here we can see the picture of Intel core to quad processor. This quad core processor. Here we can see in this we have number of cores, 4 cores in this picture. Now we are going to see the most popular presently. Maximum people are using Intel Core i series processors. Those are i3, i5, i7, and i9. These are also called i series or Intel Core family of processors. These processors became very popular in the market. The maximum in every desktop and every laptop, we can find any of these processors. First we see the Intel Core i3 processor in the series of i series processors. Intel Core i3 processor, developed and manufactured by Intel, the Core i3 is a dual core computer processor available for use in both desktop and laptop computers. It is one of 3 types of processors in the i series, also called the Intel Core family of processors. The Core i3 processor is available in multiple speeds, ranging from 1.30 GHz up to 3.50 GHz, and features either 3 MB or 4 MB of cache memory in it. It utilizes either the LGA1150 or LGA1155 socket on a motherboard, where LGA means LAN grid array socket for inserting the microprocessor on the motherboard. Core i3 processors are most often found as dual core having two cores. However, a select few high-end Core i3 processors are quad core featuring four cores. Core i3 processors are often used in laptop computers due to their lowest heat generation and conservative battery usage. Some laptops can be used for up to 5 or 6 hours on a single battery charge when running a Core i3 processor. The most common type of RAM used with a Core i3 processor is DDR3-1333 or DDR3-1600. i3 processors manufactured in terms of different generations from 1st generations to the 10th generations. This is a picture of Core i3 processor developed by Intel Corporation. Now we will see Intel Core i5 processor. This is developed and manufactured by Intel. The Core i5 is a computer processor available as dual core or quad core. It can be used in both desktop and laptop computers and is one of four types of processors in the Intel iCore family i series. The first i5 processor was released in September 2009 and new generations of the i5 continue to be released till 2020. Intel Core i processor is available in multiple speeds ranging from 1.90 GHz up to 3.80 GHz, and it features 3MB, 4MB or 6MB of caches, nothing but cache memory. It utilizes either the LGA1150 or LGA1155 socket on a motherboard. Core i5 processors are often found as quad core having four cores. However, a select few high-end Core i5 processor features six cores. Here, LGA means land grid array. It is a type of 1150, 1155 types of LGA sockets on the motherboard. These sockets are used to inset our i5 processors on the motherboard. Nowadays, each and every motherboard is having the facilities of these CPU sockets. In earlier motherboards, there were no such type of sockets on the motherboard, so all the CPUs were fixed permanently on the motherboard itself. If any problem comes to the microprocessor, we use it to remove the entire motherboard and we use it to change with a new one. But nowadays, if any processor fails, we can change the processor easily. We can remove the processor from the socket and also we can insert new one on it. So now there is no need to change the entire motherboard. There is a facility of sockets, CPU sockets on the motherboard presently available. The most common type of RAM used with a Core i5 processor is DDR3 and DDR3-1333 or DDR3-1600. However, high performance RAM can be used as well if it's supported by the motherboard. Core i5 processors are commonly found in desktop computers for most everyday use and some higher performance needs. Some laptop computers feature Core i5 processors as well to provide improved performance over heavier usage needs. So nowadays maximum laptop computers are coming with i5 processors. These are the pictures of i5 processors. This is the i5 8th generation. This is the picture of beneath the processor. These are the pins where we can insert these pins on CPU socket on the motherboard. Now, next one is the Intel Core i7 processor. Intel Core i7 is a line of Intel CPUs which span 8 generations of Intel chipsets. They feature either 4 or 6 cores with snap frequencies between 2.6 and 3.7 GHz. The first i7 processors were released in November 2008, and the new generations of the i7 continue to be released till 2020. Now the Intel Core i7 processors has become very popular and being used in most desktops and as well as laptops. Intel Core i7 processor. The variations of the i7 processor are manufactured for a variety of personal computing devices. Some high-performance i7 processors for desktop computers such as i7-8700K are unlocked for overclocking. High-frequency i7 processors, which conserve energy as much as possible at the expense of some performance, are manufactured for desktop computers, laptop computers, and mobile devices also. The i7 processor is marketed primarily to gaming enthusiasts and digital artists such as filmmakers and animators. Because in multimedia applications, especially for filmmakers and animators and gaming enthusiasts, they require higher capacity of graphics facility and high-end speeds. For this, i7 processors fits exactly according to their needs. So i7 processor based laptop and desktop computers became more popular for gaming personals and filmmakers, animators, especially in multimedia applications. This is a i7 Intel Core i7 processor. Here this is the bottom side of the processor. It's the top side of the processor. i7 processor picture. Here we are seeing. Intel also has released a limited edition i7-8086K. It means in June 2018, Intel announced a limited edition i7 processor that is nothing but i7-8086K to commemorate the 40th anniversary of the 8086 CPU, because before 40 years the microprocessor 8086 were most popular. Still, we are learning 8086 microprocessors in our syllabus. Almost all BTech students and diploma students are learning 8086 microprocessor details. Only 8086 of these processors were produced to commemorate, to remember the 8086 features and popularity. The Intel has developed limited edition i7, nothing but i7-8086K. It is the first Intel processor to reach speeds of 5 GHz without overclocking using Intel Turbo Boost technology. So we can say it is a very faster CPU which has developed by the Intel Corporation. Here we can see the picture of Core i7 unlocked limited edition. Core i9 processor. Intel Core i9 is a line of Intel CPUs introduced in May 2017. Core i9 CPUs feature as few as 6 and as many as 18 cores with 2 threads per core when hyperthreading is enabled. Its frequencies ranges from 2.9 to 3.0 GHz and up to 5.0 GHz when using Intel Turbo Boost. So now the fastest CPU available in the market is Intel Core i9 processor. It can serve up to 5.0 GHz when using Intel Turbo Boost technology in it. Intel Core i9 processor all core i9 CPUs interface with a new Intel socket type LGA2066, a LAN grid array socket. Therefore, they are not compatible with previous generation motherboards. So we must purchase new motherboard to fit i9 processor, which contains LGA2066 CPU socket on it. The core i9 series starts with the 8-core i9-9900K. The flagship and faster processor is the 18-core i9-9980XE. So nothing but in this we are having 18 processors on it. There are several other models between those, each with different number of cores or clock speed. So Intel is manufacturing i9 processor or i5, i7 or i3 processors in different number of cores and different clock speeds. So we have to purchase the required processor, either i3 or i5 or i7 or i9, based on our requirement and also based on our requirement speed. This is the Intel i9 processor, picture of i9 processor, and bottom of the processor where we insert, bottom where we can see the pins, this can be inserted in CPU socket LGA2066 on the motherboard. So my dear students, so far we have discussed in lengthy of various processors like Intel P4, nothing but Pentium 4, Xeon, Itanium, and AMD processor, Athlon processor, Core to Dual processor, Dual Core processor, Quad Core processor, and next Intel Core I series family of microprocessors i3, i5, i7, and i9 and i9 processors. So these are the popular processors in the market today. Based on our requirement, we purchase our CPU. Thank you.